So today we have the most insane, world's fastest desktop CPU for 3D rendering that you probably shouldn't buy. Also want to quick mention that I kind of lost my voice with a head cold last week, so if you find it, let me know. That's right guys, today we have AMD's just released world's first 64-core desktop CPU processor. I'm going to be talking about it in more depth, but wait, hold up. What are you doing? Get out of that comment section. Don't go leaving some silly comment about how my voice sounds like Kermit the Frog or whatever. Don't do that. I see you. Okay. Back to the video. So today we have AMD's just released 3990X Threadripper processor. This thing is the world's fastest desktop CPU for 3D rendering. It has 64 cores, 128 threads. The system I have here has 64 gigabytes of RAM running at 3600 megahertz speeds. Yes, that's now accomplishable with the newest Ryzen 3rd gen CPUs like this one. And obviously, since we're all visual effects artists here and interested in 3D rendering, we're gonna mainly be doing just 3D rendering benchmarks, mainly with Blender 3D actually, because that's what most of us use here. And it will also take advantage of all of those cores. So I right away obviously had to fire up Blender, render some benchmarks. Let me just say that, holy cow, it is fun to see 64 cores and 128 threads just ripping through your renders. And I think that AMD deserves a slow clap on this accomplishment. It is pretty insane, the technology that we now have, and AMD honestly has no competition at this level. So before we get into the benchmarks, let me quick talk about who this CPU is aimed for, because it's definitely not meant for everyone. And that's because most tasks, actually including Windows' own task manager, doesn't work with 64 cores and 128 threads. Software just isn't really optimized to use it. So in most cases, definitely games and stuff, you're not gonna see any performance increase with all of these threads. It is mainly designed at people like us, visual effects artists and stuff, that use those CPU cores for 3D rendering, so it can absolutely take advantage of all of those cores and all of those threads and achieve our tasks even faster. For example, a perfect use case for the Threadripper 3990X processor is the scene you can see being rendered behind me right now, actually on the Threadripper processor. This is the just finished 3D Bob Ross scene that I created on a previous video, and I'm actually rendering out the animation right now using this CPU processor, and the results are pretty insane. I can't wait to share with you guys that benchmark. So let's quick talk a little bit about how I'll be doing these benchmarks, and it's actually kind of challenging because I wanted to put another processor in my benchmarks to compare the Threadripper 3990X with, but the problem is there's no other processor in the world like it. There's absolutely no competition for AMD at this level. There's nothing right now that has 64 cores and 128 threads in a desktop processor, so I had nothing to compare it to. So you guys don't know what a good score is compared to a normal score. So what I actually decided to do was compare it with my current workstation, which is actually another Threadripper CPU that I went out and bought when the 1950X was released a few years ago, and I've been running ever since in my personal workstation. So I thought it might be an interesting comparison to see how far Threadripper has come from its first gen 16 core processor to its third gen 64 core processor. So that's what I'm gonna be throwing in the benchmark. So you guys will be able to see just how much faster it is than my current workstation setup. So first off, of course, we have to run Cinebench R20 because that would be fun on a processor like this. And as you can see, the results really speak for themselves. I'm sure it's the fastest single CPU desktop processor speed to ever exist in this application. And that just happened a little bit too quickly. So I think we could actually get better performance rendering even more intense workflows. So the benchmarks I picked out are real world applications where you're rendering advanced, heavy 3D scenes that will really take advantage of 64 cores and 128 threads to accelerate the workflow, except for the first benchmark here. Just for kicks, I thought we'd throw the classic BMW scene at it and see just how fast the Threadripper 3990X is. And here you can see it obviously renders insanely fast in just 32 seconds, the fastest CPU score by far that I've ever seen on this benchmark. So next we have the Blender 3D barbershop scene. This is actually a benchmark made straight out of the short film Agent 327. So it is a nice real world workflow of how much faster a scene like this made from a short film will render in Blender. So as you can see, the results really speak for themselves. And as you can see in this benchmark, it is 4 times faster than the original gen Threadripper 1950X that I'm currently using. And that is because obviously it has 4 times as many cores, but The base clock is 500 megahertz less than the Threadripper 1950X, and a few reasons for why it is still 4 times faster. Because of all the improvements that AMD has made to the Threadripper CPU since the first gen, like the improved memory improvement and stuff, the structure of the CPU, it is actually rendering still 4 times faster, so that's pretty cool to see. And the next benchmark I have up here is from the Gooseberry Project, the Victor Blender Benchmark. And again, this one is a very complex, heavy scene. It requires a lot of RAM to render this, about 10 gigabytes, I believe, actually. And obviously, it was insanely fast, the 3990X. It's really fun to just sit back and watch 128 threads rendering your scene. It's pretty entertaining. And actually, one of the most incredible accomplishments of this 64-core, 128-thread processor from AMD is that it's running on a 280-watt power draw. And that is actually insane for 64 cores. I mean, obviously, 280 watts is a high power draw, but when you compare it to that many cores, that's something that's never been done before. That is insane. But obviously still with a 280 watt power draw, temps are gonna be a concern and you're gonna need a good cooling option. The system I'm running here has a 360 all-in-one cooler. And after stress testing the CPU for like 5 hours straight, rendering the Bob Ross animated scene you see behind me, temps was sitting right around 68 degrees Celsius, which is totally acceptable. They would spike occasionally a bit higher, but immediately come right back down. So it definitely requires good cooling, but with good cooling, it is definitely rock solid, and I had no issues whatsoever rendering hours on end. But as you can see, rendering through these benchmarks, the results are pretty insanely good. Something that was really exciting about the CPU, though, is yes, it has a base clock of 2.9 gigahertz, but it actually has a boost clock of all the way up to 4.2 gigahertz. That's really cool because generally you have to sacrifice high core speeds for more cores, but AMD has managed to work their boost technology into the CPU to still give you boosts of up to 4.2 gigahertz. And doing some testing on that, I ran some single core threaded tasks in Blender, like our smoke simulation, and as you can see here, it is right up there with the competition. Actually finishing these more single core tasks very impressively quick, and that gives you a lot more flexibility with the CPU as you can also use it for some of those single core tasks. Obviously it is meant for multi-core workloads, but you can still get those single core performances out of it when you need it. I imagine gaming actually wouldn't be too bad on the CPU, even though you don't need that many cores for gaming, the boost clocks would still give you the performance you need. And then the next benchmark I have here is one of the heaviest scenes, if not the heaviest scene I have created, because there's just so many different assets in this scene. There's millions of blades of grass, millions of leaves all across the scene. It is a very heavy forest scene that I created in Blender. And as you can see, something like this really requires a lot of processing power to render. And then finally, I rendered the Bob Ross scene as a benchmark with this CPU. And this is a heavy scene as well because there's a lot of volumetrics going on in the scene. It screamed through it, as you might expect, at an insanely fast score. So I'm sure a lot of you guys are going to be interested to see how this compares to GPU rendering, because everyone knows that for a long time now, GPU rendering has been by far the fastest option for 3D rendering when it's supported. So I went ahead and compared the 3990X 64-core processor with the 2080 Ti using OptiX, which is the fastest GPU you can run right now in Blender, compared with the fastest desktop CPU, and the results were actually very comparable. While lighter workloads like the BMW benchmark scene was 30% faster on the 2080 Ti GPU, very similar results within a few seconds of each other rendering some of these benchmarks. Heavier benchmarks like my Bob Ross 3D scene took about twice as long on the GPU compared to the 64-core CPU. So in conclusion then, obviously most people should not go out and buy the $4,000 Threadripper 64-core processor because you can get similar results on a $1,200 GPU, but GPU rendering has a lot of limitations, and that's where crazy CPU rendering like this is really exciting because first of all, it's very common that GPU rendering doesn't support everything that CPU rendering does, and oftentimes with GPU rendering, you're going to have the limitation of VRAM on very complex scenes that you won't be able to render all in the memory on a graphics card. So you're gonna need CPU rendering, and that is where this CPU is aimed for. Those professionals that are running very heavy, very complex scenes that they're rendering, and they need to be able to throw a bunch of RAM at it and have it render it without issues. So that's where it's really exciting that AMD is making these accomplishments. So in short, the AMD Ryzen Threadripper 3990X 64-core 128-thread processor is the world's fastest desktop CPU processor for 3D rendering, but you probably shouldn't go out and buy one unless you're planning on rendering the next Toy Story movie on it. But for most of us, a Ryzen 3rd Gen 8-core or 16-core processor is going to be all you need, paired with a good GPU for 3D rendering. I'll put some of my hardware recommendations as Amazon links in the description below that you guys can check out. But that's going to do it for me, guys. Hope you enjoyed this video. Let me know if you did with a like or comment, and I'll see you all in a future video. Bye-bye!